Hi guys, this is Jay, your community manager, and today I'm here with Edilson, our CEO, and I'm gonna ask him some questions that I'm pretty sure that you guys also have. So, let's get started again?
Yeah, let's start again.
So, you register data on 4 public blockchains, right?
Yes.
Bitcoin, Ethereum, Ethereum Classic, and Decred. Does it mean that people will have access to my documents and to my contracts?
No, we don't store content or documents on blockchain, because we rely a lot on privacy and security. We have no access to the content of your documents. So we register on blockchain just the hashes of the documents, who can prove the authenticity of the documents. The hash is like a DNA. Every digital document or digital information has a kind of DNA. And the hash we use is the same used on some kind of digital certificates. And it's very important because with the hash, you can't reproduce the document, the original document.
Okay. Yeah. So if I go, for example, to the Bitcoin blockchain, the only thing that I see is those hashes that are related to the documents.
Those hashes related to the documents. And on Ethereum Classic, you can find the signatures of the documents. So you can find the hash related to the document and the signatures of each signatory or signer.
Okay, so in that case, no, people cannot have access to your data, even though it is a public blockchain.
Yeah.
What is a blockchain ID? What can it be used for?
Blockchain ID was created for giving access to education, healthcare, for people who doesn't have access on identities. We created the blockchain ID, firstly for signing documents. We believe you need to prove yourself doing digital acts, digital actions. And for doing that, you need to be identified by an identity. And the blockchain ID is important because today we have some external agents linking our properties, our assets, our home, our vehicles to our identity. And having a blockchain ID, you don't need the third party linking things to us. Our things will be linked on our identity directly. It's very important and very different comparing to the general digital certificates the government issues. They always need an external agent, and when you have a blockchain identity, your things are on your identity with you.
So, in a way, this blockchain ID kind of solves 3 problems, right? It provides identity for people who don't have it. You usually say that it's 1 in every 7 people in the world.
Right? 1 in 7
that's,
people.
It's a lot. You also provide this identity layer for the internet, because we, I don't know if you saw, there's this cartoon on the internet,
yeah.
Nobody knows you're a dog.
Yeah.
So, you also solve that. And additionally, you are removing the intermediaries from the process.
For sure.
So it's like threefold.
Threefold the things, yeah. Very important things.
Yeah. Are you going to store my personal data on your server? Are you GDPR compliant? For those who don't know, the GDPR is the general data protection regulation that is now in force here.
Yeah, we don't store content. We don't store your personal data with us. We just use your data for validation. And after the validation, your data is deleted. Your data is stored just with you on your mobile phone, and you deliver your personal data to any platform you agree delivering. If you don't agree, your data is, will not be delivered to the platform.
Okay. Because a big problem that we're having, for example, with Facebook, with a lot of platforms, is that they have our personal data. Sometimes they get hacked, sometimes they get leaked.
They use artificial intelligence on top of all those data, and the data is being transformed on another richer data. So, and we don't store, we don't want to store, and we don't need to store. OriginalMy proves anything is authentic without having the data or without having the contract. If we are hacked, I believe we will not, but if it happens, we will not leak any kind of information. It's very important.
In that case, you don't have to worry about that.
Yeah.
So, can you tell us more about your token, the ABC? what can I use this token for? Do you have any plans for it? What's gonna happen?
Yeah. ABC means Anti-Bureaucracy Coin, and it was created in Brazil because we know about bureaucracy over there. We know a lot of bureaucracy in Brazil.
We know a lot about bureaucracy.
Yeah. And the Anti-Bureaucracy Coin was created for fighting against the bureaucracy and fraud on the internet, on our digital things. Today, we will receive the ABC as a method of payment for accessing the services we already have on our platform. And on the future, soon, we will use the ABC for rewarding the decentralized network of validators. Today, we are the first validator of it. When customers use our mobile app for onboarding, we are the first validator. On the future, we will have a decentralized network of validators, and we believe the validator must be rewarded. They did some kind of proof of work on top of the data, and if they helped the network for being richer on reputation of the data, we believe they must be rewarded. And customers on the future, and customers who delivers their personal data straight directly to platforms for authenticating or any kind of platform, could be an e-commerce, could be an website in general, we believe the customer must be rewarded too. So today you have three things for using the ABC: for accessing the services we already have and products OriginalMy will deploy in the future, the reward for the decentralized network of validators, and for rewarding customers too.
Okay. So in that sense, the ABC is pretty much an utility token,
yeah,
right?
Sure.
It's not a security token. You don't have to register at the SEC.
No.
You don't have any problems with that.
No, because it's just we have uses for the token. Mm-hmm. The token don't represent
investment contract.
In an investment contract.